Mr. Reuven Rivlin, the President of the State of Israel in the Armenian Patriarchate. Your Excellency, Mr. Reuven Rivlin, President of the State of Israel. Dear Mr. President, it gives the Armenian Patriarch and the Brotherhood of St. James and the Patriarchs and the heads of the sister churches great honor and pleasure to welcome you in the Armenian Patriarchate of Jerusalem. The heads of churches of Jerusalem are gathered here to welcome you in the spirit of Easter, which is peace, love, and victory. Your Excellency's historic visit to congratulate all the Christian denominations in our Patriarchate goes a long way to prove your friendship and respect towards all the Christian communities in this holy city of Jerusalem. Your visit creates a precedence which expresses your government's respect towards all religions which form together the mosaic of the Holy Land, and we sincerely appreciate and hope that such visits will become a regular event. This is an auspicious occasion for us to express our gratitude towards Your Excellency for the keen interest that you have expressed towards the history of the Armenian nation, and specifically your contribution and untiring efforts in your state. At this crossroads, as the followers of the Messenger of Peace, we, all the Christian communities, once more assure you that we will continue to pray in our churches for long-lasting peace between Israel and all its neighbors. No doubt in our minds that such peace will not only benefit the people of Israel and its neighbors, but also the entire world. Mr. President, we thank you for your visit and pray for your health and success. Shalom and welcome. I would like to invite His Beatitude Theophilos III, the Greek Orthodox Patriarch of Jerusalem, to deliver his speech.
Your Excellency, Mr. President, Rivlin, the President of the State of Israel, Your Beatitudes, Your Eminences, Your Graces, esteemed government officials, dear friends, it is a great honor for us to greet you, Your Excellency, during this holy season in which we share in our celebrations of Pesach and Pascha. Once again, we are united in the reality of our common humanity and our common cultural heritage. This is a clear witness of our common Abrahamic roots in our beloved Holy Land, and this season is a source of joy and inspiration for us all. We celebrate Jerusalem as the Mother Earth of our common religious, cultural, and spiritual traditions. The Abrahamic traditions bear witness to the sacred history, a history that gives meaning and purpose to every life. This message is of paramount importance, especially at the time in our present history, when in the world as a whole, and in our region in particular, humanity is experiencing confusion, fear, and violence. It is precisely in these circumstances that the witness of Jerusalem must deliver us from every prejudice. We see evidence of our shared heritage in the book of Acts of the Apostles, where St. Peter quotes the words of the prophet Joel. In the last days it will be, God declares, that I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh, and your sons and your daughters shall prophesy, and you young men shall see visions, and you old men shall dream dreams. Then everyone who calls on the name of the Lord shall be saved. During this season of Pesach and Pascha, Mr. President, in the triumph of light over darkness, of freedom over slavery, of righteousness over evil, of truth over falsehood, Jerusalem calls on the name of the Lord and Savior. Jerusalem embraces all humanity, and it is a spiritual home of everyone who loves the God of love. Our shared joy at this time of the year comes from our passing over from the drought of the desert to the sweet waters of a green and pleasant land, from bondage to liberty, from the ashes of death to the fullness of life, a promise that the prophet Joel declares that God offers to all who hope and firmly believe in Him. I think this message we've heard a few days ago in the memorial ceremony in Yad Vashem. Recently, we have celebrated this hope of renewed life in the agreement between the three communities for the restoration of the sacred edicule of the Holy Tomb in the Holy Sepulchre. This is a worthy project in itself, but it represents a deeper commitment to maintain the holy sites as meeting places between God and man, where in the spiritual renewal that they give us, we pass over from despair to hope, an experience that touches countless pilgrims from every nation and every religious and cultural expression. Time and again, Your Excellency, we are deeply appreciative of your presidency and your steadfastness in your public condemnation of all forms of prejudice, violence, and terrorism from whatever quarter it comes. We also applaud your commitment to freedom of worship and religious expression for all the peoples of the Holy Land. As we celebrate together this season of our common hope in God for a new future for the human family, we take this opportunity to wish you, Mr. President, well in your ongoing service. It is our firm prayer that during your time in office, peace and reconciliation may come to prevail in our region and in our Holy Land, and of course in Jerusalem. Thank you, Chag Sameach.
We are honored and pleased I avail myself of this opportunity to extend greetings, prayers, and good wishes at this special time of the year when we celebrate humanity's great stories of liberation, our respective feasts of Passover. As Moses never lost faith in God, the task of leading his people to pass over from slavery to freedom, and our Savior and Lord Jesus faithfully fulfilled his mission, so may all of us maintain faith in the Almighty God, with whom all things are possible, as we continue the difficult and all-important work of passing over for more authentic justice, liberty, and peace. Recently, the church leaders of Jerusalem met in Atlanta, Georgia, in an effort to promote closer and more effective collaboration in the enormous task of working for justice and freedom for Jews and Arabs alike. In this region, where walls separate one community from other, we must be courageous in opening our doors and hearts to all, regardless of their religion, gender, or nationality. The Church must use her potential and good relations for a greater solidarity and advocacy to break down all kinds of walls between peoples. Mr. President, aware and appreciative of your profound sensibility to equity and equality, I would like, as a friend, to raise some important wishes. As a friend, I wish the government of Israel would recognize that, ignoring its Christian citizens, church leaders, and other concern, is not an advantage. Greater willingness to listen to them, as you are doing now, would greatly advance good relations as friends. I also wish that the Ministry of Education would show more consideration to the contribution made by the Christian schools to Israeli society. And specifically, I would like the Minister of Education to fulfill his promise when he pledged the 50 million shekel to our schools to end their strike, which to date remains an unfulfilled promise. Mr. President, you know well the importance and value of a good education for our young students. You are familiar with the preoccupations of our fellow Christians living in the educational forum, and we hope that you, as a friend, can help us find appropriate solutions to these issues. You have indicated on many occasions that you are the president for all peoples who call the Holy Land their home, and that the entire human family are children of one God. I remember very well and with pleasure our meeting in Tabqa last year, where you have defended the rights of minorities in the country. For your eloquent words and actions all year, we are most grateful. We assure you of a continued remembrance in our prayers as you fulfill the responsibility and obligations of your exalted position. Thank you for your visit. In occasion of your next independence celebrations, we wish peace and prosperity for all the people of Israel. Thank you.
Patriarchate's speech.
Your Excellency, Mr. Ruben Rivlin, President of State of Israel, Your Beatitudes, Empresses, and representatives of the Christian communities and esteemed guests. It is indeed a pleasure and an honor to officially welcome you all to the Armenian Patriarchate of Jerusalem on this very special occasion, as Orthodox Christians joyfully celebrate the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ. Mr. President, we are especially honored by your visit here today, which is a clear manifestation of your compassionate regard for the diverse peoples who form a part of the beautiful mosaic in Israel, and in particular here in the holy city of Jerusalem. We, the Armenians, resident in Israel and in Jerusalem, appreciate very much the sensitivity you have shown in the past towards the Armenian community's genocide-related issues, even though it has cast you sometimes into the crosshairs of Israeli political life. Last year, the 100th anniversary of the Armenian genocide pained the hearts of every Armenian around the world again, serving as a horrific reminder of the inhumanity perpetrated by the leaders of Ottoman Turkey beginning in 1915. While celebrating together again today a blessed Holy Easter season, we reflect on our deep commitment to our Christian faith, which has often led us into persecution and death, just as the Jewish people suffered for their commitment to their faith. In this sense, Armenians have an affinity with believers of the Jewish faith. The Nazi regime somehow felt the freedom to commit the atrocities of the Holocaust because of what the Ottoman Empire had perpetrated against the Armenians, as the world at large remained silent. I must acknowledge the courageous stance you personally have taken on the issue of genocide recognition has been greatly appreciated. We pray that God will guide you as you lead the way forward, always mindful of your childhood memories in Jerusalem, where Armenians seeking refuge from the Turkish atrocities found a home. Those descendants remain here today as loyal citizens of this country, just as desires of a peaceful and safe existence like Jewish and non-Jewish residents alike. Mr. President, on this noteworthy occasion, I wanted to take the opportunity to present you with a small gift on behalf of the Armenian Patriarchate. We know that our Jewish and Christian forefathers were Adam and Eve. May this Hollywood statue, the work of the late Armenian artist Hagop Avakian, serve as a reminder of all of our beginnings, regardless of faith. We thank you for being with us today and extend our prayers to you for the success of your endeavors in the essential goal of peace for the survival of all humanity, and in particular, for the people of Israel. For us, the resurrection promises that in the end, all wrongs are made right. Ultimately, death loses, hope triumphs, and life and love prevail. May the Heavenly Father bless us all and lead us down a righteous path for the greater good of all humanity. Once again, we welcome you and thank you for your visit today.
my distinct honor and pleasure to invite His Excellency Mr. Reuven Rivlin, the President of the State of Israel, to deliver his speech.
Masquerade, the the residents of Jerusalem, my fathers, my parents, my family, so all of those refugees arriving in the thousands. In Jerusalem, they found shelter. No one in Jerusalem denied the national massacres that had taken place. We are morally obligated to point out the fact, as horrible as they might be, and not to ignore them whatsoever. As a member of the Jewish people, victims of the Shoah, as you have mentioned, and endless of other persecutions, I stand here today in the shrine of the Armenian community and pray with you together. May God bless the souls of all victims. I would like to end my prayer from your Easter message. May the city of Jerusalem become the city of hope for the region and for the whole world. Thank you and amen, amen, amen.
Thank you.
No help to the health of Jerusalem,
I know.
To the health of the state of Israel.
Thank you.